Now, the most useful advice I could give about the firewall table, first and foremost, is that for most users, you're not going to have to deal with this. Most people have much better ways to allow or disallow connections coming from incoming clients from other computers. But if you have no other option to disallow connections to the PI server, then this firewall table here will allow you to specify either allow or disallow to certain IP addresses or domain names. And that's something that will only affect incoming connections trying to connect to PI. Won't do anything about trying to connect to any other application. So I'll show you how it works. If I create a new IP address or a new firewall entry here, let's go with 192.168.70.170. If I were to specify I want that to be disallowed, and what that does is it means that we're simply going to disallow that as an incoming connection to PI. Yeah, so here's one entry that allows every IP address in the world. This one disallows that specific IP address. And I can also do this by masks here. I can go with the entire range here. Let's go with asterisk, and we'll specify that to disallow. Yeah, there we go. That would disallow everything that has those first three octets plus whatever other IP address at the end there. When people do use this, if they have real tight security, what we typically see is they would go ahead and disallow access to everybody in the world and then specifically allow certain users or certain domain ranges here. So for example, this turns it kind of around such that now, well, I didn't really need that last one there, but now we've got every IP address within this range here is going to be allowed and no other IP addresses in the world. Now, let's say, for example, that you wanted to disallow this specific IP address right there. This is like a waiting room or something like that. You could specifically disallow that while allowing everything else in this subnet. So that would specifically disallow that one specific computer. Now, this does look like a kind of an ambiguous situation because under one criteria, it's allowed. Under a second criteria, it's disallowed. So which one takes precedence? Well, it's whichever firewall entry is more specific. So since this is more specific to that one specific IP address, then we will disallow it in this case. Now, we could have also specified that last one. We could have specified that using the domain name. So if this was, for example, called gatehouse.mycompany.com, I could disallow that specific entry there. And now we're getting an entry here that it checked. That doesn't actually exist. I'm going to go ahead and add it anyway, just as an example here. So that would be an example where I could, well, let me go ahead and disallow that. And that would take the place of this right here. But again, the best advice really is that for most customers, they're not going to be using this PI firewall. So for most customers, you'll just leave the default. And the default was to allow all IP addresses in the world like that. And then to just go with the default entries like that. And then you would use some other mechanism, your regular firewall within Windows, to allow or disallow access to that computer. But if that's not available to you, you can use this within the PI server, but it will only disallow connections to PI. It won't do anything about other incoming connections.